July of 2009. I was walking to work on my usual morning walk. I would cut through Central Park to sort of clear my head a little bit, and a giant branch fell from a tree on top of my head. Finally, 7 months after the accident, they discharged me from the hospital. It's a brain injury, and that those are really unpredictable. What changed was I didn't care about the same things as much when I had to come to the office. I couldn't get there the same way. I couldn't take the subway anymore because it wasn't wheelchair accessible. I was like, oh, doesn't anybody know? Like, this is messed up.
Wheelchair accessible routing in maps has been something that I've wanted in maps for pretty much my whole lifetime that I've been in a wheelchair, which was, you know, from age 2 onward.
I think it really is useful to learn and to approach individuals who are different from you. The first step is to figure out, let's talk to all sorts of users and make sure that their experience with my product, with my idea, is good.
In 2016, there was a hackathon, an accessibility sprint week, and I saw a project that Rio put out there for making Google Maps accessible in terms of route finding. I thought that was such a personally meaningful kind of project, and I was so excited to jump on board.
What we came to it with was, well, what if we improved maps and improved, in particular, the transit directions within maps by showing which public transit routes are wheelchair accessible? And so that's how that started. And so we built a small demo of that within 1 week long sprint.
Yeah, we were a ragtag team of Googlers just united by a common cause.
All in all, it took probably more than a year to go from hackathon to actual product in the user's hands.
I mean, a lot of the pushback before it launched was, well, what if the elevator goes out? What if this, what if that? All totally valid concerns. But always, our line was just get it out there, and it won't be perfect, but it'll be so much better than having nothing at all. And then that's how we'll find out what's working and not. You know, once it's out there, that's how people will know. And so that's what we've done, and it's been rolling forward since.
When you use the public transit option as opposed to walking or driving, it gives you the option to say, how do you want to go? One of which is wheelchair accessible. And so when you select that, what happens underneath the hood is Google Maps goes into its database, figures out what routes, what train stations, what transit options are accessible based on the data we have, and reroutes you such that if, for example, the first route that you were given might have been the shortest one, but actually going through a station that you couldn't use for a variety of accessibility reasons, you could actually ignore those stations and reroute your stations, and so you would have a route that actually works for you.
The way that transit agencies can provide this data is through a data format called GTFS, or the General Transit Feed Specification. Being able to know from Google Maps, hey, you should avoid this station that's inaccessible, let me route you with a way that is accessible, that's kind of life-changing because it gives you that sense of independence and confidence back when you're traveling. Accessibility should be built into the app from the ground up. Adding those accessibility features is unlocking usability for a huge, huge portion of the population.
It's this virtuous cycle of physical accessibility that we're all actually already a part of it, you know, like it or not, if you exist in the world. Visibility is sometimes the first step. Just, you know, having a video like this out there and people say, oh yeah, that can sort of lead to more awareness. So then it's just on their radar somewhere. Then the next time they're building an update to their map, they'll say, oh, is this wheelchair accessible? Once you have that access, then people with disabilities, people with mobility needs, they show up. And when they're there, when we're there, we're seen. And when you're seen, you're real. And that starts the cycle again. That's that kind of visibility. And then there you go. Wanting the developer community to sort of just see that visibility, that we're here. It's a moral thing to do, it's the right thing to do, but it's an opportunity. We're users, we're customers, and we have families. Just from a, you know, pure nitty-gritty dollars and cents perspective, it's a good move.
Maps has a particularly important responsibility in helping decipher the real world, and I think the ability for someone to just use an app to enter a space, to be part of a business is a basic right.